Good morning and welcome back to the channel. Today is Remembrance Day and I'm here at the Town Hall because today we're going to be following the parade so that if you couldn't make it today, you can see what happened. You'll be happy to know that I won't be talking on this one. I'm simply going to record the events and let you watch them. So, over to the parade.
Thank you. Let us remember before God and commend for his sure keeping those who have died for their country in war, those whom we knew and whose memory we treasure, and all who have lived and died in the service of humanity.
Would anyone laying a wreath please come forward to the edge of the pavement? First wreath. Deputy Edward Allen, Deputy to the Lord Lieutenant of Somerset. The Mayor of Glastonbury Town Council and the Chairman of Street Parish Council. Royal British Legion Glastonbury Branch and the Royal British Legion Street Branch. A wreath on behalf of the Right Honourable James Heaton, MP for this area. District Council, Somerset County Council and Glastonbury Town Council. St John's Church, St Benedict's Church, St Mary's Church, the Methodist Church and United Reform Church. St John's School and Edgley School. Glastonbury Sea Cadets, Glastonbury Air Cadets. The Burma Star, Help for Heroes and the Royal Air Force Association. Avon and Somerset Police, Devon and Somerset Fire and Rescue Service. Glastonbury Scouts, Cubs and Beavers, the Women's Institute. Are there any other organisations in that they are with? St John's Ambulance. Glastonbury and Somerset Gypsy Council. And great-grandchildren of a war veteran. Thank you.
Hema War Memorial in Northeast India. When you go home, tell them of us and say, for your tomorrow, we gave our today.
They shall grow not old as we that are left grow old. Age shall not weary them, nor the years condemn. At the going down of the sun and in the morning, we will remember them.
We will remember them.
Thank you. Almighty and eternal God, from whose love in Christ we cannot be parted, either by death or life, hear our prayers and thanksgivings for all whom we remember this day, fulfill in them the purpose of your love, and bring us all with them to your eternal life, through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with each one of us, now and always.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Right, stand up. Peace!
Thank you. Thank you. go by, remembrance becomes more and more pertinent. And I'm minded of the words of Air Vice Marshal Mike G. Lloyd during the service. It's not only the fallen that we're remembering, but indeed the families of all those who have fallen. And I'm minded of the words of the King in 1919, who said at the Armistice Day commemoration that they were remembering the fallen and all those who remain. Thank you very much for remembering today. Parade Marshal, permission to dismiss. First toast will be to His Majesty the King. Thank you very much for coming today. It is absolutely extraordinary, isn't it, to think that whilst we're remembering those who have fallen in conflicts that have affected this country, we are witnessing a war in Europe. And I would like to raise a toast to all those who are serving currently in Ukraine, and may a speedy end to that war be achieved, hopefully in the not too distant future. So to all those who are serving in Ukraine.
Ukraine.
And finally, of course, to all those who have fallen and all those who are left behind, to the glorious dead, we will remember them.
We will.
Thank you very much.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that's it. The Remembrance Day Parade from here in Glastonbury. I hope if you didn't make it or you couldn't make it, then today's video has been useful. And I look forward to seeing you next week when we shoot the carnival. But for now, thanks for watching. Bye-bye.